How you been?
Good.
Good to see you again.
Real good.
Making it, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Might have to turn your hat around, it's gonna be breezy. I'm just kidding.
This young dolphin came barreling straight at the pelican. They love the pitch of that small motor.
This is the AM we're throwing. Garlic infused soft plastics, AM fishing. Man, these things stink and them redfish can't stand it. They gotta have some, man. I don't know what color this is. This copper and chartreuse tail, I like it. Good job. We team casted him. Oh, he was sitting right on the edge of that hole, man. Had to have that AM lures, boy. That thing got some stink on it.
Yep.
I saw him suck it up. The pelican strikes again. On the boat. I just dropped anchor back here. Oh, that's a big fish, sir. Don't let him come back here, though. Just turn his head if you can. I got the anchor out. Oh, that's a big one. Hey, he's dang near a bull.
Ooh,
what?
I was standing. I could see that fish on the edge of a pothole and I instructed Mr. Mike to bring it across the pothole, stop, boom, jumped right on it.
I'll net him, make it easy on us.
Thing, isn't it?
Good job.
Look at that.
Wow. Congratulations. You did just the perfect thing. Just the perfect thing. I know you couldn't see him, right?
No, I couldn't.
Yeah.
They just told me where it was.
You just listening and just, yeah, that's perfect. Simple plastic worm hook and an AM lure.
Yeah.
Just lightly falling into these potholes. Works like a charm.
No weight.
Just that.
Like bass fishing.
Just that slow descent. They can't stand it, man. They got those in Kansas?
No redfish in Kansas. No redfish in Kansas. That's a beautiful thing right there.
It sure is.
Look at that. Go get him, big boy.
No worse for the wear.
A fish like that's going to be probably coming up on his fourth year. He was born in the spring, probably. So he's probably almost 4 years old. They grow fast when they're young.
Okay.
They add a lot of length.
Right.
But then when it's hard to tell a big fish how old it is because they grow very slow when they get to be old. But when they're young, like these 18-inchers, they're 2 years old.
So you figure how 6-7 inches a year or what?
Well, when they're young like that, they grow 8-9 inches a year.
Okay.
But then when they get up there, once they get above 25-26 inches, they don't add but an inch or two usually. Some of these fish can live 40 years.
Wow. Them big old bull reds.
Right. They redfish have been, you know, they age them by the scales, and they some of them live 40 years.
Come on.
So that's why it's fun to release them.
Yeah.
Grow up, reproduce.
Make some more, yeah.
Be some more next time.
We had a beautiful drift, light drift on these Bahama style crystal clear flats.
Got
the big 46er inch drift sock out today, guys.
The bite slowed down, so we moved closer to the shipping lanes where the water was a little murkier to see if that made a difference. And we were getting a lot more strikes right off the bat.
So how old will he be?
Two.
2 years old?
2 years old. Just about right.
Well, that's just your second hit. I think this murkier water is helping.
The wind had built up to maybe 12 to 13 miles an hour, but with that 46 inch drift sock, it feels like it's blowing 3 or 4 miles an hour. It slows us way down, gets everything under control. I love that thing. Very light accessory to keep in a kayak or a small boat.
Oh, in the hole. Man, that wind sock is doing amazing. AM lures. Oh, double up. That's a deep hole. Ooh, you got a good one.
As we're slowly drifting through, we can see these deeper holes. We're pitching the AM lures in there, letting them sink, and look, boom, doubled up.
Yeah, he's gonna be a little short, huh?
You wouldn't mind telling me that story of the John Wilkes Booth doctor on camera, would you?
Fort Jefferson was built as a fort in the Dry Tortugas to protect the United States. They were afraid the British were going to invade, protect Florida. Well, after the war was over, they turned it into a prison. John Wilkes Booth assassinated Lincoln. He jumped out of the box onto the stage at Ford Theater and he broke his ankle. He rode so many miles to a doctor, Dr. Mudd. He had no idea John Wilkes Booth had just assassinated Lincoln. He took care of him. John Wilkes Booth was later captured, prosecuted Dr. Mudd for treason. So they put him in prison, the Dry Tortugas at Fort Jefferson in the dungeon. That's 90 miles west of Key West. And the soldiers started getting yellow fever. And they came to him and said, "Will you treat the soldiers? Only if you pardon me." And see, he knew, as a doctor, he knew what to do for yellow fever. They got so desperate, they said okay, and they got him a pardon, and they let him out. And he treated the soldiers and cured them from yellow fever with quinine. You can still go down there today. It's a national park. Down there today and see Dr. Mudd's cell in the dungeon.
Mr. Mike's a wealth of knowledge when it comes to fishing and the fishing industry. He's done a lot of big things over the years. Let's get back to it. Mr. Mike's throwing the smaller profile AM lure. I switched over to the AM lure 5-inch. Big dude.
There we go. Oh, AM. I think it's a baby trout color. That feels more like a red. Nope. Baby trout. That's a little bigger guy.
Oh, he's hooked up again. Same strategy though, just drifting real slow and throwing the potholes and grass edges.
Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Oh, we got him on half a AM. Look at that, man. That's a big fish.
21.
Look at this trout, man. This is some of my favorite gator trout areas.
Picture.
There he goes.
Mighty fine. That was a good fish.
They still work.
Ten fish bit that tail off, still yeah, work. It's got too much stink on it to resist. Tail or no tail.
I can see a massive black drum sitting on the edge of this pothole right here. This is the moment. I've got the perfect lure.
Oh, come on. Come on, big guy. Ah, oh, you see that? Man, that thing is 20 pounds, easy.
Look at that thing sitting right center screen. I'm pitching a big stinky AM lure, and look, I spooked him before I could get it over there. But before this, I put it to the left and right of his head 2 or 3 times, and he just refused it. They can be stubborn.
Oh man, that's a shame. Oh, there goes some sheepies.
Yeah, I think I saw some orange. Yeah, he's on bottom. That's a good red.
Mr. Mike is hooked up again. Same lure, Same pattern. He's taking it easy just blind casting and still hammering the fish.
That's a good eating size if you want to. You rather trout.
Definitely are.
Missed his jaw.
I did.
Be careful with that.
Oh, okay.
That's right. Look, there's nothing left to this AM here. Not much at all. And this still stinky enough to still catch that redfish. We're going to have to retire it, though.
These AMs don't have to be fully intact. That infused garlic stink just stays with them all day. We've even left them on hooks and caught fish on them a couple days later.
Beautiful drift.
Beautiful winter drift. Yeah. Indian summer day, man. We're in 2 inches of water now, so folks, I'm gonna have to walk us out of here.
Well,
it's in the winter time, but still no guarantee. Oh no, you're fine.
Water temp's in the mid 50s. I'm using boots.
Need one of us to get some weight off of there.
Just gotta get to the green.
That was a good day.
Nobody.
I gotta tell you, Mr. Mike, this Pelican Intruder with a 2.5, the Wildlife and Fisheries needs to look into that and make it illegal. It puts a hurt on them fish.
Hey, if you'd like to fish with me in the Pelican, the kayaks, or the boat, just hit me up, 30milesout.com. All the information's there.
Great day. Great day on the water.
Yes, it was.